Morning, Trainiacs. If you've been putting together a triathlon training plan and you're not exactly sure how to lay out a spreadsheet or a plan in general, today, that's exactly what we're gonna go through. I'm gonna tell you how to put out a triathlon training spreadsheet, and you know what? I might even give you said spreadsheet. Ooh, that's good stuff. Let's go on into the pain cavern. So if you've started laying out a triathlon training plan or you've downloaded one online, odds are really good that it looks like this. And that's the most common format to do it with, your days of the week going across the top and just going week by week, one row at a time down. That's how we laid out our beginner triathlon training program because it's the most simple way to do it. But if you want to get the most out of a training plan, there's a big aspect in that that is being overlooked. So what I'm going to show you is how my coach, Coach Pat, used to use spreadsheets before he switched over to Training Peaks to lay out a training plan that incorporates a lot of data that that traditional training setup is missing out on. So what we've got here is actually my training plan from 2017 that you can see up top left. And a couple of the key features to this are that over on the right, there are four columns that are a big indication of how well you're doing in the training program. And it's your motivation levels, your recovery level, your sleep levels, and your workouts, how they went on a scale of 1 to 10. And what you do is every single day, you fill out exactly how you're feeling with regards to all of those four key metrics. And what that does is it tells your coach or tells you how ready you are to keep going. Now, sure, you can lay out a coaching plan with here's what you do every single day, but when you're missing out on that portion of the what your body is telling you and being able to adjust your training day to day based off of that, you're missing out on a little bit of like your body response and kind of the art of coaching. And we left this out of our training plans because it's just that one step beyond what just getting started involves. And the next thing is that this also shows the cycle of the week. So we've got cycle week one, cycle week two, cycle week three, cycle week one, cycle week two, cycle week three. And that allows you to remind yourself, hey, in week one, I'm gonna push myself. In week two, I'm gonna push myself. In week three, I'm gonna back off and give my body a rest. So I'm gonna show you how to lay this out. Start by opening up a new spreadsheet. You can do this in Google Sheets or Excel. Title it, I'll go triathlon training template. In the first column, I'm going to put day of the week. In the next column, I'm gonna go training cycle week. Then I'm gonna go workout one, workout two, workout three. And that's not to say that you need to be doing three workouts a day. I just wanna leave room for if you choose to do three workouts a day. Now, here's where it gets really critical. We use motivation on a scale of 1 to 10.
We use recovery. On a scale of 1 to 10, how your sleep was, on a scale of 1 to 10, and how big your workouts were that day, on a scale of 1 to 10.
And we'll add some quick formatting here to make it look very snazzy. Then what I'm gonna do in the first column here is we're gonna put the days of the week, starting on a Monday. Training cycle weeks typically start on Monday through Sunday. Add some more fancy formatting. I'm gonna copy and paste that three times to get 3 weeks worth of training. And then here's what I'm gonna do in the training cycle week. For the first week, I'm gonna indicate all of those days as number one, because that's the first week of the 3 weeks of training.
The second week, I'm gonna indicate them all as a two. And then the third week, I'm gonna indicate them all as a three, do my fancy formatting. And then I'm going to copy and paste this
multiple times all the way down for the rest of the year. Okay, now here's where we're gonna get a little bit sophisticated. What I wanna do with those last four columns is I wanna give myself a visual cue that shows the trend of how I'm doing with my motivation, my sleep, my recovery, and my workouts. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to click bottom left and I'm gonna open up another sheet and I'm gonna insert a line chart that is going to track how those metrics are trending. And I'm gonna do this with 3-day rolling averages because you might have one bad day, you might have two bad days in a row if you just have back-to-back bad sleeps, but if you have 3 bad days in a row and you can see that your motivation is dipping for 3 days in a row, that your sleep is dipped for 3 days in a row, all of a sudden it's like, you know what, you should probably start backing off. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a cell down here at the bottom that relates back to a 3-day average of the motivation, of the recovery, of the sleep, and then of the workout. And again, don't worry exactly about how to do this because you can download this template from a link that I'm gonna give you at the end of the video. By creating that one formula, I've created the average of the first 3 days of motivation. By dragging it across 4 times, that's going to get me my motivation, my recovery, my sleep, and my workout. And then by dragging it down a whole bunch of times, it's going to translate into a nice little chart as you start filling it out. And it's showing up as an error right now because we don't have any data in there. So let's say that we fill that out and we're like 6 and 8 and 3 and 4 and we go back and all of a sudden we've got averages there. And what we wanna do is create a visual cue with a chart here that you can go to and see exactly how you're doing. So we are going to insert a chart based off of all that data. And you can see now that it instantly created a chart that as we start completing workouts here and every single day we're indicating what our motivation level is, what our recovery level is, what our sleep level is, what our work level is, if we have a moment like here where we've dipped down in any one of those, we can go back to either our coach or to ourselves and say, you know what, maybe for the next day we should back off. And there's no real rule of thumb for, well, you dip under a 6 and all of a sudden you should back it off. But if you just see a consistent downward trend over the course of a few days, that's when it's time to back off. So just start filling in your workouts here, and as you start filling them in, you can create a nice little legend for yourself that green means you completed the workout, red means you missed or cut out the workout, yellow means you had to alter the workout. So maybe you didn't complete a certain number of intervals, or maybe you couldn't hit a certain power number. It's basically just a warning sign that you tried it, but you weren't quite there. So there you go. You can actually go and download an Excel version of that template with that chart and with all of the formulas already put into it at triathlontaren.com/plan template. And then you start filling out your workouts. That's not to say that other training plans are designed improperly. We designed one that was much more simple. It's just that this is another step in training plan design. So I hope this helps. If you aren't already subscribed, hit that subscribe button below. Thank you for watching. And if you are already subscribed, smash the like button. Smash it. Hit it. Hit it hard.